So, hello everybody, or good morning, as I would have to say. I'm thinking of the time zone that my body is still in. So, I'm very happy to present to you now in this next part of this session how we at Humada Inc. see the future of the digital life, and much more importantly, what we at Humada Inc. think that we can contribute in order to get there. But before now jumping too far ahead in the future, let's take a look at where we are today. If you look at the world today, today's life is supported nearly in every facet of its shape by a large amount of digital services and platforms. They reach from the most obvious services, so the core domains of the internet, saying knowledge management, communication, collaboration, over to something that we also see naturally as digital service, namely entertainment. But more and more, we see that they even reach into very physical needs that we have in our day-to-day lives, for example, traveling, for example, accommodation or transportation, when you think of Uber. In order to understand now what the limitations and the boundaries of today's world are, we think it's important to see this as a little bit more structured and processual kind of way. If you do that, so if you structure the world as of today, process-wise, you could get a picture like that. You have the user, sometimes very irrelevant, very small, opposed by a large amount of services, completely changing all the time, which all are organized in kind of vertical silos. What I mean by that is that each of the service that provides you a very, very good service for your day-to-day life, as we just heard, is organized around this specific need and this specific service. So, nevertheless, although these services are all covering different aspects of your life, they have something in common. And what they have in common, and that's very important to understand, to see the boundaries, is they all offer you a personalized service, because if we get a personalized service, this is exactly what we perceive as valuable today. And how can they do that? That's all what they do in the same manner. They do it by getting personal information about you, by scraping it from your phones, by getting it from your browser, by even using data brokers in order to learn more about you. Because based on this one, they are able to offer you really personalized service that you will make feel like, yeah, that's valuable, and that makes you stick to this platform and the service. And seeing the presentations that we have just learned before, this is for us already the first answer why nobody is so transparent about personal information. Because in this today's vertical structure, personal information is the key asset, is a secretive source for these services in order to stay in business. Because the more you know about the user, the better is your offering, and the better your offering, the better is your market position. So with other words, you better do not give away what you have about the user, because that secures your cash flow in the future. Having said this, we are quite near to also the disadvantages of this system. And the disadvantage of this structure is that all these services today are isolated silos. So that means they all offer us a great value, but no matter how hard they try to grow, no matter how hard they try to become the one and only platform in our life, they only stay vertical silos with a limited value. So why is that they can't grow? And you see that very often today in the economy, that they try to expand and that they try to have a broader offering for the user and the individual. The reason, of course, is the following one. Whenever one of these services tries to reach out to another niche, to another aspect of the digital life, there is most of the time already an incumbent. This incumbent has a lot of personal data and thus has a certain market position. And of course, capturing this market position is even for an established player in one niche very, very hard to establish. So we think this is a disadvantage of the digital life today, because when you look at it now from a user perspective, you remember the user, the small, nearly irrelevant part of this picture at the side, he is the one that faces today two big disadvantages. First of all, having this structure, he is the poor guy that has to manage his complexity. So he is the one that has to handle one-to-N relations to all these various service providers that are changing, that are coming new, that are tested out and not proving what they said to be. So the user has this permanent hassle of orchestrating his digital life across the silos and connecting the dots. The other disadvantage, apart from this hassle of just orchestrating it, is even a deeper one, because the user in this world that we have today and that we all like and which is very valuable, no doubt about that, but the user in this world today has no chance to connect his data. That's the most important part. I think all of you can refer to it when you remember when you have, for example, booked your holiday the last time via online platforms. You go to one platform, book your flight. You go to the next platform, book your hotel. And although you have just entered the information into platform one, you're not able to take it with you to platform B, right? So you are the one that has to have the information that is visible at hand and have to orchestrate it through the silos. And thus, we are only talking about the information that you know, right? They have much more information that you don't know, which you might use for other services, but due to the fact that it's hidden in these organizations, in these vertical silos, you are not able to gather it. This is exactly the reason why we at Humada Inc. are sure that in the future, this model will be disrupted by a now horizontally organized service that is lying across all the vertical offerings, and that is for the first time built around the customer. And this vertical service has more or less the task and the role in this world to orchestrate the value and the data that is stored around a person. So that means this service will provide transparency about the personal information for each user. It will give the user access to this information and will allow the user to actually use his personal information in the verticals that might link then to this platform that is built around him. So, as critical listeners, you can now, of course, ask, hey, nice picture, I got the point. Before that, it was unstructured, now it's a little bit cleaner, right? In order to understand really what that means, we should look at the use cases that are possible by that. And without enumerating all use cases that might be possible, let's take the three most important ones. The first thing that a platform like this will offer is that it allows the user to switch service providers seamlessly without losing quality. So just imagine you go to an online retailer A, he has, in today's world, learned a lot about you, can make you a nice offer, and that's why you stick to him. If you have this trustworthy horizontal platform in the future built around you, you can also switch the service provider to a service provider B, give him access to all of your data, and instantaneously, the new player in the market can offer you something that fits exactly to your needs. So with other words, and that's the reason why we called it also very disruptive, a platform that lies across horizontally will tear down the unfair advantage of today's businesses around your personal data. So personal data is no shady asset anymore in this place, but trust is the asset while personal data is transparent. And thus, of course, when these unfair advantages are teared down, new players come into play, competition will increase, which will lead to more innovation and more value. The next use case that we see is that we see a totally new level of personalization made possible by such a platform that lies across. Why is that? First of all, each single service that we use today can be even better when we access or when we base it on all the data that we have with this platform. So it's not that Amazon, Google have to offer us something based on the data that they have today, but any provider can use all the data that is around us and can build personalized services based on that. For example, a suit like I wear today, if I have my credentials in such a platform and I go to an online tailor shop, the online tailor can immediately say, I know that you like dark suits, here is an offer, here is your size, take it one click and you have it. Of course, there is also the linkage of services. So if I then go to the next shoe retailer, for example, and allow him to see my shopping history, without any hassle, this shoe retailer could say, hey, I know that you just bought a nice suit. I know that you like dark color, so therefore this shoe here, in your size, is exactly the one that fits to your suit. And with just two clicks, without any hassle, I have just bought the suit and the stuff that I wear today. As I said, it's fiction. I had to still do a lot to get these things on today. And the last one, and then I'm done with enumerating use cases that made possible here with this platform. The last one is the most important one. We are sure that we today have no clue what is possible when we have all the data in one storage and if we can access all the data. Just let me take one example from medicine. When you go to the doctor today, normally you are already ill and have symptoms. So what the doctor can do, he can ask you a lot of questions where you can give information which is very subjective. So it's what I think has changed, what I think and stuff like that. What the doctor can then do is he can start measuring from the day on when I was already ill, which is also, when it comes to diagnosis, perhaps a little bit limited because I'm already ill when I see him. In the future, with a platform that has all the data around you, you can grant access to your medical service, physical or virtual, doesn't matter in this case, about your Fitbit, your smart scale, about your movement, how many times have you traveled. Even the information from sleeping apps can be provided to the doctor, and the doctor has a completely new basis of making a diagnosis and of then of making or curing your disease. All these use cases are only possible by having a vertical, trustworthy platform that is built around the customer and the individual. So, and we at Humada Inc. want to make this one happen.
Yeah, and one question we haven't answered so far is how do you actually build a company that is trustworthy towards a consumer? And I want to just give you a couple of thoughts on that, because Hans-Martin talked about the silos that you see today, like Google, Amazon, and others. And we believe that the new companies that are rising, like DigiMe, and even governments that are open with data, are also a form of silos. So we believe that in a world where computing power and storage capabilities are unlimited, we will see an abundance of data. And with unlimited data about everyone, you need to have a third party that steers the transactions between all these different providers. And we believe that this is a path into the future of human-centric data management, and I want to give you a very short last example. If you use your credit card, which you usually got by your bank, you probably have an American Express from a bank, Santander or Citibank or whatsoever, and you go and pay at a retailer, you don't trust the retailer that he doesn't do fraud with your data. You trust the infrastructure layer below, and that's the credit card company. And we believe you can build the same in a digital environment and enable all these new services, DigiMe, Open Governance, and other open data that use the human-centric approach to do that facing the customer. And this is what we want to do. Thank you. If you have any questions, go ahead.